Whew. What's up, y'all? I hope everybody's doing well. As always, I just pray to God just give y'all a speedy recovery for all those who are not doing good. And as always, I got to thank my A1s for day ones, and I got to continue to thank all you all who continue to subscribe to my channel. But today, it was busy, y'all. I knew it was going to be busy, but I didn't know it was going to be that busy. So while I was at the IRS building, before I left, I had to make a complaint to the security officer, whoever that guy is. And it was like, soon as I got in there, I don't know if he had a problem with me. I don't know if he had a problem with my shirt. It say black, strong black women. I don't know if he had a problem with that. Because you got to imagine, nobody wasn't even in there. The receptionist was not even at the desk. So he told me to put my stuff down so he can scan me. So I put my wallet and my phone down. And so he scanned in front of me. And he said, turn around. So I turned around. And he was like, turn around. And so I looked. I said, excuse me? He said, I told you to turn around. I said, you're making it seem like you're trying to arrest me. How you sounded? He was like, well, I told you to turn around. I said, I don't like the way you're talking to me. And so I let that go, you know, because there was nobody in there. So I just let that go. So I had went and got a complaint paper. And I was filling it out and about, you know, I just filled it out. And this paper right here, I had got this complaint paper, your opinion papers. And so when they said a question about professionalism of staff, I had put very unsatisfied. And so when I went back there to get all my typed information taken care of with the lady, I asked her what his name was. And she said, our IRS do not deal with complaints when it comes to the officer, that I have to get the number from him to call who's in charge of him. So as I was leaving, I had asked him for the number. Where the paper at? I had asked him for the number. So he gave me on a piece of paper. I'm trying to find where that number at. But anyway, he gave me on a he gave me this right here, and he put his sergeant name and the number. And so when I look, I'm thinking that's this his name. So he was trying to be slick. So he put the sergeant name, and I was like, when I was leaving, I came back. I said, "Is this your name?" And he looked kind of like, "No, it's the sergeant name." And so I said, "Well, can I have your name?" So I looked at his badge and I wrote, hurry up, in my sloppy handwriting, and wrote down his name. So when I got in the car, I told him the incident that had happened, and the guy, he was blowed. Actually, he sounded over the phone like he was blowed how the guy disrespected me. And he said, "Ma'am, I would make sure I would talk to him about this behavior." And I'm just letting everybody know, if somebody treats y'all wrong, when you go in any kind of building, any kind of occupation, anywhere you go for service, and somebody treats y'all wrong, don't hesitate to complain. Make a complaint. I don't care if you have to call the corporate office. And I know people say, oh, let God handle it. That's true too. But when somebody is like that, you have to make a complaint, because he probably did that before and somebody probably not did not believe that other person. Because I'm sure I'm not the first one you've been that rude to, because it was, for one, it was no reason to be that rude. No reason. How he told me, yelled at me and told me to turn around, even though I was turned around. It's a way that you can tell the person over again. Even if that person did hear you, you can say, ma'am, could you please turn around this way? You know, because I turned from back to front. You know, so I don't know if a different type of turnaround he meant. And so, but it's a different way you can talk to people. So if y'all go anywhere and somebody treats y'all rude, complain. Complain, because some people is two-faced. They can be another way around their employees or their boss and be a totally different way when their boss is not around or when people is not around. Because how that man said it to me so disrespectfully, I couldn't help but, like, I was taken aback. Like, literally, the way he said it, I was like, look. And then because I had turned around, I had looked back at him. And I was like, excuse me, sir? Well, you should have turned around. I'm like, wait a minute. I said, sir, I do not like how you talking to me. And so, I mean, something like that, you guys got to report stuff like that. I don't know if that man had a bad day. I don't know if he started off with a bad morning with him or whoever the case may be. I don't know if that's just his personality. I don't know. All I know, it was being totally rude. So I'm telling you guys, do not let people, I don't care if they work at McDonald's. I don't care if they work at Macy's. I don't care if they work at on the police department. I don't care who it is. If somebody disrespected you all and you feel some type of way about it, it don't connect with your spirit, how they treat you and talk to you, complain. Give that person name. Tell them what they did. Because like I'm telling you, people is two-faced. Some people probably won't even believe he said that. But if when he started getting complaints on his behavior, people will be like, well, this person said this on this date, 10/10/21, and this person said this September. They don't know each other. How come they coming up with the same complaint? You have to make complaints that let these people be believable to other people. Because people not going to believe it if you just tell somebody and they don't document it. It have to be spoken to someone in authority higher than that person. And I'm just saying that to everybody. And I mean it. I mean, because I'm telling you, the way he made me feel, it was like, I know I'm an adult, a grown person, but it kind of made me like feel like he was talking to a child. Or, and it's like, no, you definitely disrespect me, because I'm not going to feel this way if somebody were to say, ma'am, turn around more. I need you to be turned around more, even though I was fully from front. All the way to bike, I don't know what he wanted. I don't know what he wanted because he had to scan the bike too. So with that being said, everybody, I'm just letting y'all know, if you ever feel disrespected, wherever you go, call corporate. Get the person's name. Make a document of it. Don't just let them get away with that, because if it happened again, somebody report it, they're going to know, okay, this is his character when we're not around. So report somebody like that, y'all. Please do. And I know God going to handle it too, but still, on your end, report it. You know what I'm saying? So the other person can be believable. You know what I'm saying? Because like I say, two people wear two-faced. But okay, so that's how my day started, but it's not how my day going to end, because at 12 o'clock, it will be my 50th birthday tonight. Okay, so after that, I had went to the vitamin store. I went to McDonald's, got some hot cakes with sauce shit. I went to Publix and bought my own orange juice, and I just had a good day. Then I had to remember that I had to get my sticker, so I had to drive to my insurance company. And while I was in there, I said, you know what, Kathy, just see if they can lower your car insurance. So when I was in there, God is good, they lowered my insurance by $55. So I'm thankful for that. $55, I saved, like that year, I saved $300 is plus dollars the rest of the year. So I'm thankful. Any y'all go to paying insurance, call them. I don't care. Call them and ask them, is there any way they can lower your insurance? Because if I did not just volunteer and say that to them, to the lady, Miss Leslie, I would have been still paying that high insurance. So volunteer and ask that question. Call your company today. Call your car insurance tomorrow and say, is there any kind of credit I can get? Anything y'all can do to lower your car insurance? Like I said, $300 plus a year, $55, you know, I think it's like $50-something monthly that was lowered off there. So guys, I'm blessed in that area. I'm so thankful. So after I got that taken care of, I went to the DMV. And the DMV that we go to, we don't have to see a person. We can just go get our tag number, put in our tag number, and they're going to tell you if you got any kind of tickets or whatever. Yes, put mine in there. Sure enough, I had a toll ticket. Couldn't get my registration until I paid the toll. So they gave me the number and got the confirmation number, took care of that inside. So they said, well, when something like that happened, we have to take care of it inside. So they took care of it. I got my 2022 sticker. I'm happy. So guys, so far, so good. My day is going good. Quincy called me today and was like, Mom, can you pick me up from basketball practice at 4? I'm off today. Of course, I'm going to pick my son up. He's doing good in school. Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, he either made the honor roll or the dean list. When you make all A's and get one B, dean's list, principal list, I don't know. I don't know if that's considered just a plain old honor roll. But got to get claps to him. He doing so good for his first semester in, as a freshman. And I'm so proud of him because he never really gave me a hard time in school, you know, and I'm so blessed, you know. There's a lot of things I do know and a lot of stuff I don't know when it comes to ninth grade. The stuff they give to these kids these days, you know, you literally have to sit down and read it. And I'm like, Quincy, the best thing that you can do is if you don't understand, is talk to the teacher. This one, he was in literally in middle school, probably sixth grade. And so ever since I told him that, he always been doing good. Like I said, it's from elementary to middle school. He never was a kid who stayed by a hard, had a hard time in school. Even though, for some odd reason, I do not know in elementary, they sent me a letter saying something about his behavior, trying to make it seem like he was slow for some reason. And this was in elementary school, first grade, second grade. I'm like, the books that I have him for him at home, he do those with no problem. And I say his behavior, never had a behavior at home, never talked back. If they did anything, it was behind the scene when they closed the door in their room or whatever. He never was a bad child. So I'm just like, what is they talking about? And so they was telling me that all sending me letters about Quincy. Well, they actually did it to both of my boys. They didn't say it to my daughter, but for both of my boys, I know that they sent me something about my kids' behavior. And I'm like, because I'm with my kids all the time. I know some kids act different from home and when they at school, but I was like, no, they trying to make me seem like my kid got a mental issue. And I'm like, no, it's no way. And so I'm saying that just to say, the grades that Quincy making, and from how these people said in elementary, making it seem like he had a disability, I'm like, it's no way. So people, women, men, parents, if anybody from your kid's school try to make it seem like your kid's got some type of issue, slow, a mental issue, if you know that's not the case, if you home and you see how your children behave, and you know that it's not the case, do not let them put your child name as a behavior. Don't do that because they is labeling your child. And God forbid, if anything happened when it comes to a domestic or something in the street, they're going to pull records all the way back. Oh, this kid had this problem ever since they was in elementary, middle school, high school. Do not let them label your children. Don't let them label your children. Because I told them, me and my husband went to that school and we talked to those people. Do not send us anything else about my child behavior. And they stopped. I'm not signing that. I'm not signing that. Both of my daughter, they didn't do her like that. But she graduated. And she went to all these different awards, Dr. Martin Luther King, we had to go to little things for she had to get her awards and everything. So they didn't do her like that. But my two boys, they would not let up trying to make me believe that my child had an issue mentally, slow. And I am so glad I did not allow them to get in my head that something was wrong with my child mentally, that he was slow or something. I'm like, no, it's no way that my child gonna be this way at home, read, write, and then go to the school and be like, no. So I had told them, me and my husband went there, and we told them, you know, stop this. You know, I don't know what you're doing, but you're not going to label our son. We literally had to talk with the principal. We sat down there, and I'm telling you guys, do not let these people tell you your child need medicine. Do not let them do that. Do not let them do that. I don't care what kind of check they're going to try to give your child. Do not do that. I'm telling you, soon as something happened at their job, in the street, they're going to pull the records, their school records, and sure enough, they're going to be making it seem like it's your child who is at fault with doing something. They go way back. So do not let them label your child. I'm telling you, women, men, and parents, don't do that. And if you already did, and you know, it is what it is. But if you know that nothing was wrong with your child, and you allowed them to influence your head, you can't beat yourself up because you believe something that you thought was right. But if you know without a shadow of a doubt that your child do not have nothing wrong with their mental, it's not slow, then you make sure you talk to that principal. You make sure you talk to somebody, but do not let them label your children. I see that they mostly do it with boys because they did it with my two boys, but they did not do it with my daughter. So with that being said, everybody, I'm going to get ready to go pick up Quincy from basketball practice. I just hope everybody had a great day. I'm going to come back on later on, probably around 12 o'clock. That's why I hope I went was live so y'all can share this moment with me on my birthday. But I'm going to share some moments of me probably celebrating my little birthday by myself with a little cup of wine. At 12 o'clock, yes, it's going to be just a little cup. I'm home. You know, if I was somewhere else, I probably have a cup too, so I'm home. So I'm bringing my birthday with a little cup of wine, and then tomorrow, it's going to be my birthday party, only family. You know, it's going to be intimate with my family. We're going to have fun, and I'm going to video it, and then I'm going to share it and upload it with you all, and that way you all can be a part of my 50th birthday. With that being said, I love you guys. Continue to support my channel. Make sure you subscribe, share, and like. With that being said, everybody, I love you, and I will be back on around 12 o'clock to celebrate my birthday. I can't go live, as you know. But I will post it, so it's going to be after 12 for you all. So with that being said, everybody, love you. Peace.